Welcome to the Isle of Knowledge. Have you ever thought that what will happen to us if the North and South Poles flipped? What will happen if the South Pole became North and the North Pole became South? Before going into details, let's do some background checking for the South and North Poles. In simple terms, poles are the two points on the planet where the axis of rotation intersects the surface. The North Pole is the point on the Earth's surface that is located at the northern end of the axis of rotation, while the South Pole is located at the southern end. As most of you are already aware, the North Pole is located in the Arctic, near the north end of Canada, while the South Pole is located in Antarctica. Technically, there are two points to be known as North Poles. The location of the first North magnetic pole changes every day, according to what is happening beneath the Earth's crust. The second one is named the North Terrestrial Pole, which is the fixed point that marks the top of the Earth. Both locations sit in the Arctic Ocean. Interestingly, there is a third one as well, that is called the geomagnetic North Pole. Over the past century, this geomagnetic North Pole has moved from Greenland to Canada. The North Pole is generally warmer than the South Pole. The temperature at the North Pole can reach 0 degrees Celsius in the summer, and minus 34 degrees Celsius during the winter. On the other hand, the average temperature of the South Pole is around minus 60 degrees Celsius. The North Pole is only a couple of feet above sea level, and absorbs heat from the Arctic Ocean, whereas the South Pole is located 9,000 feet above sea level. Interestingly, there is only one sunrise and one sunset in a year that occurs at the North Pole due to the tilt of the Earth's axis. From early April to the end of September, the North Pole has 24 hours of daylight, and a sunny summer always. For the South Pole, the summer starts in October and lasts till February. During this time, the sun is almost always in the sky. And at the peak of the summer, the sun doesn't set at all, which is called the midnight sun. The poles have long been a focus of exploration, as they are some of the most remote and least explored places on the planet. Many famous explorers, such as Robert Peary, and Roald Amundsen, have made expeditions to the poles. And today, people continue to visit the poles for adventures. But why do we care? What is the importance of the South and North Poles? The answer is the Earth's poles are important due to a number of reasons. The North Pole is used as a reference point for navigation, and it is the starting point for all lines of longitude. The South Pole is also used for navigation, particularly in the southern hemisphere. The Earth's magnetic field is created by the movement of molten iron in the planet's outer core, and it is this field that causes a compass needle to point north. If the field were to flip, the magnetic North Pole would move to a different location on the Earth's surface, and a compass would no longer point north. The Earth's axis of rotation is an imaginary line that passes through the center of the planet and extends from the North Pole to the South Pole. The Earth's axis is tilted in relation to its orbit around the Sun, which is what causes the seasons. The polar regions play a crucial role in regulating the Earth's climate. The ice and snow cover at the poles reflects much of the sunlight back into the atmosphere, helping to keep the Earth's temperature in balance. This process, known as the albedo effect, is an important part of the Earth's climate system, as the reflection of sunlight by the polar ice caps helps to balance the warming effect of solar radiation. In addition to reflecting sunlight, The polar ice caps also help to regulate the Earth's temperature by releasing large amounts of cold fresh water into the oceans. This cold water helps to cool the oceans, which in turn helps to regulate the Earth's overall temperature. Polar regions are important to regulate ocean currents through the process of convection. As the polar waters cool, they become denser and sink to the bottom of the ocean. This sinking water then moves towards the equator, where it is replaced by warmer, less dense water that rises to the surface. This movement of water, known as a convection current, helps to circulate the oceans and plays a key role in regulating the Earth's climate. There is another way that the polar regions help to regulate ocean currents, which is through the formation of sea ice. As polar waters freeze, they release large amounts of cold, fresh water into the oceans. This cold water is denser than the salt water in the oceans, and it sinks to the bottom of the ocean, where it can help to drive ocean currents. If the South and North Poles flip, it could dramatically affect the Earth's climate on the ground and the sea. Geomagnetic reversal can change precipitation patterns. The poles also play a role in the Earth's water cycle, and a flip in the poles could lead to changes in precipitation patterns around the world. Some areas might experience more frequent or severe storms, while others might experience long droughts. Further, it could change the atmospheric circulation as well. The Earth's atmosphere is driven by the movement of heat and moisture from the equator to the poles. A flip in the poles could disrupt this circulation and lead to changes in wind patterns and weather systems. If the Earth's poles were to flip, it could have significant impacts on animal migration. Many animals, such as birds, whales, and some species of fish, rely on the Earth's magnetic field to navigate and migrate to different parts of the planet. A flip in the poles would involve a flip in the Earth's magnetic field, which could disorient these animals and make it difficult for them to migrate. For example, birds that migrate over long distances, such as Arctic terns and red knots, rely on the Earth's magnetic field to navigate. A flip in the poles could cause these birds to become disoriented and unable to find their way to their usual breeding or wintering grounds. Similarly, whales and some species of fish also use the magnetic field to navigate, and a flip in the poles could affect their ability to migrate. A flip in the poles could lead to significant changes in temperature in the Arctic and Antarctic regions, which could affect the survival of both plants and animals that live in these areas. For example, a flip could cause the Arctic to become warmer, which could lead to the loss of sea ice and the animals that depend on it, such as polar bears and seals. A flip in the poles could also lead to changes in the distribution of plants and animals, as some species may be better adapted to the new climate conditions. This could cause shifts in the distribution of animals and could lead to the loss of some species in certain areas. Okay, now the important question. Can Earth's South and North Pole flip? Yes. In fact, it had happened several times in the Earth's history, and the last one happened about 780,000 years ago. As per the experts, geomagnetic reversal is the process by which Earth's magnetic field flips its polarity. In this process, the North and South magnetic poles switch places. The process of geomagnetic reversal is not well understood, but it is thought to be related to movements in the Earth's core. Changes in the distribution of mass within the Earth, such as the movement of the Earth's mantle, or the formation of large land masses, are believed to have a greater impact on geomagnetic reversal. This can have significant consequences for the planet and its inhabitants, including changes in the Earth's climate, disruptions to animal migration, and disruptions to human technology. According to scientists, the magnetic field must weaken by about 90% up to a threshold value to cause a reversal of polarity, and during this time more cosmic rays, high-energy particles from other parts of the universe, can hit us due to the lack of a magnetic shield around our planet. As per some scientists, Earth's magnetic poles are long overdue for a switch. But the good news is that geomagnetic reversal, the process of flipping the poles, is a rare event, and it is not something that is likely to happen in the near future. Even though it is too early to predict bizarre phenomena like these, what we are certain is that you can learn something from our videos and hopefully implement them to find ways to protect and benefit our society for the upcoming generations. With all being said, we wish you a happy and joyful day. Thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing, liking, and sharing, which means a lot to me. I love to see your thoughts in the comment section.